Hiya. I'm just wondering, have you got any rooms available tonight?
Multi-millionaire Tony Banks usually stays in five-star hotels.
Don't wet the bed and don't bring brasses in.
Brasses? What's that?
Prostitutes.
Okay.
Now this wealthy businessman has decided to live a secret life in one of the UK's most deprived towns.
Oh my God, this is 100 metres from my house.
This is what you call Anfield. There's always something going on.
To volunteer to come and live in this must be off my head.
For the next 8 days, he'll live undercover, secretly looking for people he can help.
I'm visually impaired, but that doesn't define who I am.
Even from the grave, I think sometimes he helps me.
The experience will make this tough ex-soldier confront his past for the first time.
Does it bring back some memories to you?
Sorry.
It's okay, mate.
I've bottled up too much. I haven't spoken about it. You need to get your emotions out. That's how you'll deal with all this shit that's going on.
At the end of his stay, he'll give away over £100,000 of his own money.
I think it's a big burden to have to choose.
And he'll change lives forever when he reveals that he's a secret millionaire.
That was the best.
Tony's away, but he should be here in a minute. He should be landing in a garden. As you do.
I think anybody who knows me, I'm not a flash type person. I like nice things, but I'm not flash. In fact, I would say probably quite humble.
Money is no object for 47-year-old Tony Banks. Whatever he wants in life, he can afford.
This is the gym, and in here we've got various bits of equipment, running machines and weights and all that sort of stuff. Through here we'll have the sauna. And going outside, we have the hot tub and jacuzzi with the outside telly. We like to relax and drink the odd glass of champagne. When I first realised that, you know, I was a successful millionaire, it was actually a scary place to be. It was something that I felt a bit guilty about to a certain extent, because I thought, how has somebody so stupid as me managed to do this?
Hi, it's Tony here. OK, how's your staffing today?
Tony made his fortune running care homes for the elderly. His business empire is worth £50 million, making him one of Scotland's richest men.
I'm driven because I'm absolutely shit scared of being a failure in life and not having the wealth and the success that I want. So that drives me to do bigger and better things. I think my work ethic has affected my life and relationships in my life because of the way I work.
Tony's hunger for success means he doesn't get a lot of quality time with his family, as his partner Maggie knows only too well.
We've decided all together that you're working too hard and too much.
Is that unanimous?
Yeah. By making himself busy, he doesn't have to think much about the past, okay? Or, in fact, any other problems.
And it's the past Tony would rather keep hidden away. In 1982, he was a young soldier called up to fight in the Falklands.
Well, in this drawer, I keep a couple of mementos from the Falkland Islands, from my trip down there. This is me. I was 20 years old. I was one of the older guys in that photograph. Chap beside me, he was only 18. He was killed. There was 9 other guys in this picture killed, all just young men. It just fills me with great sadness. The 1980s was quite a hard decade for myself and for my family. I'd been in the Falklands and seen a lot of death there of young guys. I came back and my two brothers died in the 80s, both aged 34. One unfortunately drowned, committed suicide, he was a solicitor. And then a few years later, my other brother, he was diagnosed with a brain tumour. And it affected me to the extent that I've never visited my brother's graves, and it was all very, very sad. I tend to want to keep my emotions to myself. I don't want to be seen to be weak. And maybe my way of dealing with it is just to forget it and shelf it.
I think that if he did open to these experiences and face them, I think that would cause a huge relief for him in his life.
For the next 8 days, Tony will live a secret life. He'll look for and be introduced to people who may need his help.
What have I let myself in for? I think that this will allow me to evaluate my whole life and maybe some of the things that I've not addressed and dealt with. and also it will allow me to spend some time, hopefully, helping somebody that's in a place that maybe I was there once.
Tony will be travelling to Liverpool. He'll tell the people he meets he's an ex-soldier looking for a new line of work. While he's away, he'll have to survive on the equivalent of Job Seeker's Allowance.
I feel a bit apprehensive now. I'm probably actually worrying for the first time because I don't have a clue who I'm going to meet and the situation I'm going to be in. And it's that lack of control thing, I think, that really gets to me.
Tony will be living in Anfield, in a small area next to Liverpool's multi-million pound football stadium. During the 80s, local jobs were lost and people moved out, leaving behind rows of boarded up houses. There's hope a massive regeneration project will bring the area back to life. In the meantime, people still live amongst the hundreds of houses awaiting demolition.
I'm off to Anfield, mate. Where's that?
Go straight through there, go up towards London Road, right hand side.
Is that far?
It's about 15 minute walk.
What's it like?
If you want to go to Anfield and you want to go there, keep your wallet down your underpants and don't put it in your back pocket because it'll be pinched.
All right. See you, boys. For fuck's sake, where am I going? Is it Beirut? And the siren in the back sounds like it's maybe Beirut. So I'm really, you know, it's a bit more apprehensive now than ever about going down to Anfield. It's just unbelievable, isn't it? I mean, everything is boarded up. The whole thing is boarded up. I wouldn't want to live here. Not in a million bloody years. Never. What's it like around here, mate?
Randia is allowed a dump. I wouldn't come around here if you paid me.
It's full of drug addicts, you know, kids burning houses down. It's not good, it's not a good place to be. It's a living hell to live in an area like this.
Terrible
at this moment.
Have you been here a long time?
4 years now.
Too long.
Well, you know, hoping to get out. You know what I mean?
Every man for themselves up these neck of the woods.
I am absolutely cacking myself of what's going to be happening for the next week. It's just absolutely shit in the back. Fucking hell. Nice smell. Shit hole. That's a fucking fire hazard for a start, isn't it? You need 2 days in here just to clear the place out of shit to make it habitable. Razor Wire City. Who would want to break in? There's fuck all to steal. To volunteer to come and live in this must be off my head. First night here, thought I'd just nip to the corner shop to get some food. Watch, there's some smoke over there and it looks like there's a house on fire. Obviously somebody set fire to one of the houses. It seems to be quite common around here when you're looking at it. Here's the fire brigade. They're ready to get the thing put out. It's a shithole and they're making it worse by setting on fire. I mean, it doesn't make sense to me. I mean, this is probably an every night occurrence. I bet this happens every night. This is like no big deal to the fire brigade. Well, here we go again. Let's go to Anfield. There's another house being set on fire. It's just chaos. It's absolutely chaotic. It's just mayhem all over the place. It's just... It's Beirut. It's just an unbelievable place.